Muslims in Davao City attend the Eid al-Fitr congressional prayer to mark the end of the month-long fasting. Hernel Tokmo joins us now with that story. Go ahead, Hernel.
Stanley, hundreds of Muslims were gathered at the Rojas Avenue here in Davao City early Wednesday morning for the centralized Eid al-Fitr congressional prayer in the observance of Eid al-Fitr. The entire Rojas Avenue was temporarily closed for a few hours during the event, in which the male and female attendees separately occupied the adjacent roads. During the event, Muslims held a prayer to the Almighty Allah and listened to the preach of an imam who reminded them to value the teachings of Islam. Muhammad Al-Kulaki, president of the Mercy Islamic Foundation, expressed his gratitude, stating that the entire holy month of Ramadan, as well as the Eid al-Fitr, was concluded in peace. He prayed for peace and progress in Davao and also in the entire Philippines. Al-Kulaki also thanked the city government for the assistance during the Ramadan. The city government said it provided food packs to the Muslim for their iftar or fast-breaking meal in the evening. He said that the Eid al-Fitr was also a way to thank Allah for saving and for making the fasting easy for them during the Ramadan. The Davao City Police also reported more than 600 attendees in the congressional prayer with no reported untoward incidents. Reporting from Davao City, Hernel Tokmo, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Hernel. U.S. President Joe Biden criticizes Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu for making a mistake in Gaza. Biden expressed concern over Netanyahu's actions, particularly regarding strikes on aid personnel in the enclave. The American president also expressed his desire for Israel to propose a ceasefire. Over 33,000 Palestinians have been killed in the six-month war, while many of Gaza's 2.3 million people are at risk of famine.
Because I think what he's doing is a mistake. I don't agree with his approach. So what I'm calling for is for the Israelis to just call for a ceasefire, allow for the next 6-8 weeks total access to all food and medicine going into the country. I've spoken with everyone from the Saudis to the Jordanians to the Egyptians. They're prepared to move in. They're prepared to move this food in. And I think there's no excuse to not provide for the medical and the food needs of those people. They should be done now.
The British government rejecting pressure to suspend weapons exports to Israel over charges of humanitarian violations in Gaza. That statement coming from British Foreign Secretary David Cameron in a joint news conference with U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken. Cameron says this is based on their latest assessment of the situation in Gaza, though he admits that concerns remain.
The latest assessment leaves our position on export licenses unchanged. This is consistent with the advice that I and other ministers have received, and as ever, we will keep the position under review. Let me be clear, though, we continue to have grave concerns around the humanitarian access issue in Gaza, both for the period that was assessed and subsequently.
The U.S., which is by far the largest provider of weapons to Israel, has also rejected calls to suspend weapons shipments despite rising frustration with Prime Minister Netanyahu's conduct of the war.